Hey guys, so for today's video, we're going to be talking about some products that are new to me. So one product that I'm going to be talking about in this video and showing you a demo of is the Pat McGrath Skin Finish Foundation. This foundation, I have been wanting to try for a while now because I'm in a lot of Pat McGrath groups and I love seeing everybody's skin. I love just seeing all the looks and stuff that they create with her products. So I was very excited to try this product out. I picked it up in the shade Deep 30. And I'm also going to be trying the new Laura Mercier powder in Honey. If you know me, you know I'm a big fan of Laura Mercier. Since this powder came out, I have been wearing it. So yeah, here's the medium deep powder. And that's what that looks like. And then here's the new Honey powder. So you can see right away that is definitely lighter. This one's for like natural setting on my skin tone. This is definitely not for like brightening any areas of my face. This one, though, I would definitely be able to brighten up areas of my face with this. Yeah. We're gonna go ahead and get into this. I've already primed my face with the Milk Makeup moisturizer, and I've already did my brows. So like I said, I am wearing the shade Deep 30, and let me go ahead and put some of that on. Okay, so this foundation is very liquidy, like it is very watery. This foundation gives you like a very skin like appearance. You definitely want to make sure you blend down your nose areas. So I'm just going to use a brush. I'm going to start over here and just dip. Okay, so now I'm ready to actually apply the Honey shade to my face. I saw this. Okay, so I'm not gonna swipe it off my face yet. I'm actually gonna spray my face and then kind of melt that into my skin, which I saw this girl I follow called Ashley. She did this, so I wet my sponge and now I'm gonna kind of press that into my skin so it kind of melts in. See that girl? Okay. You see that? I definitely. I like that. Okay, so I'm just gonna take it down my nose. Okay, so my face is basically done for like an everyday type look. I'm gonna go ahead and add blush to my face. And what I'm gonna be using is Buried Away from Minted Cosmetics. And I really haven't used this shade yet. I usually use clay too much. And I kinda like adding it to my nose. I like the little warmth that it gives to my nose. Yeah, whatevs. Since I use this Pat McGrath foundation, I'm actually going to use her highlighter kit as well. And I'm going to be using, I think it's Bronze Nectar, I'm pretty sure. It's called Bronze Nectar. It's not up here. It's listed in the little like sheet you get, but here is what they look like. So yeah, I'm going to be using the bronze shade and I'm going to go ahead and just apply that. Okay, I'm not going to do a lot. I'm just going to put a little on my bridge, not really down because I don't want my tip to be, I don't want my nose tip to be shining, but I just kind of want the bridge to look, have the light bounce off of it a little. Yeah, a little under my brow. Okay. So we used some new products today that I hadn't really shown on my prep channel, and that was the Pat McGrath Highlighter Trio, the Pat McGrath Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation. We used Laura Mercier's Honey. We used Buried Away from Minted Cosmetics. And I do my eyelashes with the Lash Freak mascara from Urban Decay. They were kind enough to send me this, so I've been trying it out a couple of days. The first day I did not like it, I'm gonna be honest. Last few times that I've used it though, I actually liked it because I figured out what I was doing wrong. Use this part, you know, swiping your lashes, and then you'll take the tip and just work each individual lash or whatever, and then you'll use the back of it to actually lift your lashes. So I was not doing all that the first time I tried this mascara because I was like, that is a lot of work. But when I did that, my lashes looked very, very good. Okay. So we're gonna work it. Okay guys, so you can definitely see that, wow, the other lash just looks really pathetic right now. It looks really sad right now. Wow, this is crazy. So yeah, it definitely did something for my lashes. Something that I'm definitely feeling, I'm liking the way it looks. And now I'm gonna use my favorite pinky nude color, and this is from Nami Beauty. And this is the color Kima. About some of these products that we tried out today. So the Laura Mercier powder, I'm definitely feeling it. I definitely feel like this will be my new go-to under eye setting powder. It retails for $39 for 1 ounce, so you know, you get a lot of product and you're not really using it a lot, so this should last you for a very long time. For the next product that we're using today that was somewhat new, not really, the next product that I'm going to talk about is the Pat McGrath Sublime Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation. This foundation is very lightweight. Let me actually, I think it retails for $69, I think. Oh, it retails for $68 for 1 fluid ounce. And this foundation is very watery. But it gives you such a great finish on your skin. Like, look at my skin, y'all. Look at it. Like, it looks amazing. I need to tell you what shades are what, because I always find it weird whenever I watch videos and they never really mention the shade, or they'll mention it once. But they won't put it in the title. They won't put it in the description. They won't put it anywhere because they want you to watch the video to find out. And then sometimes they never even tell you. They'll just show it on the screen. And I'm like, that is not cool. Trio of highlighters from Pat McGrath, like I said before. I have been wearing this one a while now. I wear it a lot in some of my looks that I've done, but I haven't really posted pictures of some of the looks I've done because Corona, all this stuff has just been a lot on my conscience, and it's just, I didn't really feel like doing like looks. I didn't feel like really doing a lot of these things that I normally would be doing. So, but let's see how much this runs. But I love this thing. Like, I love each and every one of these colors. I feel like you can mix all three together and get a really, really pretty highlight. And you get 3 highlighters for $50. So that's a good deal. Go ahead and talk about the next item that I tried in this video, which is the Lash Freak mascara. I am not a big fan of most mascaras because they generally don't really do anything for my eyes. But you can definitely see that my, like, you saw my plain eyes before. They weren't really giving you anything. They were sad. But now they look very lifted and just, I like the length and I like the volume that they gave with this mascara. If I didn't like it, I would not even show it. And that's generally what I do with products. If I don't like it, I don't even talk about it most of the time. And if I do talk about a product that I don't like, something is definitely wrong with it. So I want to tell my viewers about it. But let's see how much this one runs. Urban Decay. I'm looking at Sephora for all these prices, y'all. So the Lash Freak mascara run you $25. And they also have a mini version for $13 if you want to try it. Blushes in this look, I use Buried Away. And I normally use Clay Too Much, which y'all are probably tired of seeing me use that, but it is just so pretty. And you have Buried Away, which is what I use today. And this, you see the intensity of this? This is beautiful on my face. I actually want to add a little bit more because I love blush. Like, and this reminds me like the first blush I ever wore of my mom's, and it was like a fashion fair blush, and it was just, it was beautiful, like, and it made me really love blush. So big ups to Minted for these blushes. Like, these are amazing of these shades to me. So that is all four shades right there. So that's Clay Too Much, Peach for the Stars, Pinky Promise, and Buried Away. The intensity is there. Like, Minted does it again with their products. Minted never gets it wrong with their products, and that's what I love about them. This is my go-to pinky nude lip, and this is from Nime Beauty. So this is the color Kima. Like I said, this color is just really gorgeous. I love it. Anytime it's in stock, I'm trying to get it. It wasn't in stock the last time I looked, but y'all see this color? Like, it is so pretty, and it's just so natural looking, and it's perfect for just everyday wear. It's perfect for any kind of looks, honestly. I mean, I could make it work with anything because I love it so much. I think that's probably why I feel that way, because I just love this color and I love that brand, because she is an amazing artist and she runs an amazing company with amazing products. And she also just did her first official collab with Glamazon 1026. The girl is bad. Like, she is so gorgeous, and she has such a great spirit, and I love to see the things. I love seeing what she's doing right now, because it is amazing to see.
Bye.
Say bye bye. Good job, buddy. Bye bye. Bye, guys.